This is a public service announcement. Due to the recent rise in webcam usage around the world, we've seen a significant increase in bad and sometimes disrespectful webcam etiquette. Please pay attention, because your job and your reputation are at stake. This is no laughing matter. Please pay attention, and whatever you do, do not be a webcam willy.
Rule number one, dress for the occasion. Unless you're just chatting casually with friends, if you're in a work-type setting, well, then you need to make sure that you have dress that is still appropriate, even though you might be at home. Willie's Disney onesie isn't gonna cut it. And now he just looks like he's trying too hard. There you go, that's much better. And yes, you can keep the blue blocker glasses. Rule number two, look into the camera when speaking. It's easy to forget to look at the camera when it's your turn to speak. If you're like most, you look at the person you're speaking to on the screen instead. Would you look at a person's chest when you speak to them in person? So don't do it on a webcam either. If you need a reminder, cut a little triangle out of a sticky note and point it toward the camera so you know exactly where to look. Rule number three, don't be too close to your camera. Even though you're speaking virtually with someone, there's still a sense of personal space that you can invade. No matter what country you're from, this is not an attractive look. Try to frame yourself chest high with some room above your head too. There, that's better. Great job, Willie. Rule number four, position your camera at eye level. Try to position your camera at eye level for a more natural look. Too high, and you'll look like a little Willie. Too low, and you'll look like Godzilla. Eye height is the right height. So once you find your position, Goldilock it in, and you'll be golden with your webcam. Rule number five, keep the camera steady. If you happen to be taking a call on your mobile device, make sure your camera is steady. It can hurt other people's eyes when you bounce around a lot or move the camera all over the place. You'd be better off letting people know you'll be turning the video off for the call if you know you're gonna be moving around a lot. Rule number six, beware of backlighting. Light coming from behind you makes you look like a dark figure. Unless you're trying to hide something, Willie, then it's best to light your face from the front for the best look possible. If you're able to move around, plant yourself in front of a window and have the natural light wash your face with a glow comparable to your favorite filter on Instagram. Or you can use an LED light to achieve the same effect too. You look great, Willie. Rule number seven, managing your background. Now that we've fixed you up, we need to make sure your background looks great too. Let's make sure everything is cleaned up and tidy and there are no unmentionables seen on camera that could distract the purpose of your meeting or conversation. Items like bookshelves look great behind you, especially when they are a little further away, which can add some depth to the camera view. There, that looks way better. Great job, Willie. Rule number eight, managing your computer. Beyond your physical background, we have to be aware of the computer you're on too, especially if you plan on sharing your screen at any time. Turn off or silent all notifications, close any unnecessary apps, tabs, and programs, and make sure your background image is suitable for other people to see too. Oh, Willie. Rule number nine, fight the urge to fidget. Willie has a big problem. When he's at his desk, he likes to fidget with things. This is normally not a problem, but on a webcam, both on audio and video, fidgeting can be a major distraction.
Stop.
Pens clicking.
Stop.
Robot noises.
Stop.
Fidget spinner.
Stop.
Desk tapping.
Stop.
Post-it note flipping. Juggling.
Okay.
If you know you have a problem like Willie, then move all the fidgety things around you out of arm's reach so you don't distract the other members in your group call. Rule number 10. If you need to make noise, hit the mute button. Sometimes during a call, you have to make noise, like when you're about to sneeze or cough. Or perhaps your kids come into the room and you need to tell them something. Whatever it is, you have the ultimate weapon to fight against unnecessary sound, the mute button. Smash that mute button like you smashed the like button in this video, because really that would actually help quite a bit. And thank you. Rule number 11, drink water. Willie forgot to drink water today. That's no good, especially for webcam chats. Just listen to what his voice sounds like.
Hi team, it's good to see you today.
That's kind of gross. And it's because Willy's mouth is dry. This is the one time in your life that you actually want a wet Willy. Let's make sure to drink plenty of water and even have some water close by in case your mouth gets dry during the call. Better, Willy? Good. Rule number 12. Don't speak over others. Wait your turn. Internet delays can cause uncomfortable situations like this.
Yeah, so hey,
okay,
before
so,
you...
Okay, so, hey, Will...
No, I mean...
No, wait, you...
Sorry, go
Willy,
ahead.
Can you let...
No, go ahead, go ahead. You're okay. You're all right.
Ugh.
Okay.
Be courteous to others. And if you have something to say while somebody else is talking, you can try to raise your hand to claim the next thought. Give everyone a chance to speak too, and hopefully we'll all have better conversations because of it. Rule number 13, use headphones. This isn't always necessary, but it's best to use headphones or earbuds for several reasons. Number one, there's a potential audio feedback and echo that can happen when sound from your computer comes back into the microphone. Secondly, especially if you're in a work call, use headphones or earbuds so that other people around you aren't listening in on your conversation. Rule number 14, use the chat to communicate, but don't overdo it. The chat area can be a great way for people to communicate and share items while somebody else is talking, but don't go overboard here. Say only what's necessary and don't be like Willy, who's both talking about something irrelevant and apparently he's that guy in the group chat we all hate who breaks a single thought into several broken up messages. Don't do that. Rule number 15, blink. Sometimes when the camera's on, we hyper-focus and forget to blink sometimes. It's a little creepy, especially when you have RBF like Willy does. So just imagine you're having a natural conversation with someone. There's no need to overthink it. Just blink. Rule number 16, don't mess with the digital backgrounds. It's easy to get excited about the fun digital features a web-based chat platform can offer you. But depending on the purpose of your call, it may be best to leave those features for happy hour later on. You don't want to be a potato during an important conference call, or forget you have some personal backgrounds that you were saving for someone special. Right, Willy? And lastly, and this isn't a rule, it's just a general statement, smile and have fun. Studies prove that smiling makes you and the other people around you feel better. And in tough times, especially, a smile can go a very long way. Remember, although we're digitally meeting now, there are still human beings on the other end of those webcams, and more than anything, we need to be there as humans, helping humans, no matter how digital or how disconnected we all feel. Smile.
Hey, what's up? It's Pat Flynn here. Thank you so much for watching this video. I had such fun putting it together for you. Let me know in the comment section below, what tip did I miss that came across your mind? You've been doing a lot of these Zoom calls and meetings, obviously, online recently, perhaps, and I'd just love to know, from your perspective, what's one thing that you've implemented or seen or perhaps want to warn people about related to webcam use? Leave a comment below, and also make sure you hit subscribe. Here on this channel, we talk a lot about entrepreneurship, starting a business, whether you're starting from scratch or scaling the one that you have. I myself was laid off in 2008, and as many of you know, right now we're going through this crazy crisis in 2020, and it's definitely a time of opportunity for a lot of people. So the question I want to ask you is, what does this make possible? You don't have to answer that right now in the chat below, but answer that in your head. What does this make possible? Anyway, I want to encourage you moving forward. Please stay safe. Thank you so much. Consider subscribing, and as always, Team Flynn for the win. Peace, and click on this video next. I think it'll be helpful for you.